Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to understand what is triggers. Okay, so triggers are stored programs which are automatically fired or executed when some event occurs. Okay, so and these events can be DML, DDL or any DB operation. So basically, if you are inserting a value in a particular column or deleting a particular value in a column and you want a trigger, something to something to be fired so that the user can get notified is known as triggers. So let's see the syntax and then an example. Example will make triggers very clear for you. Okay, so this is the syntax. So create or replace trigger, trigger name. Okay, so create or replace trigger and you'll give a name to it. And when you want this trigger to be fired, so it could either be before, after or instead of. Okay, so before insert, update, delete, basically you have to tell before insert, update, delete or after insert, update, delete or instead of this is what you want the trigger to do basically. Okay, so this is the syntax. So either it can be before insert or after insert or something like that. Okay, of which column. Okay, column name of a particular table, on which table. Okay, of the column name, column name could be name, birth date or anything like that, and on the table name, referencing old as O, new as N. So basically when does a trigger get fired? Basically before or after you are inserting, updating, deleting. Basically when you insert a value, there will be an old value and there will be a new value which you are inserting. When you're going to update, there is going to be an old value and the new value with which you're going to update, and delete similarly for delete. So you have to reference old as O and new as N in case you want to put some condition. You need these values, old and new. This line is optional. You can you are basically giving an alias to old and new. Otherwise you can simply use old and new also. For each row, basically for which particular row. For each row means you're going to this trigger is going to be fired for every row. When, and then you have to give in condition in it, when whatever the condition is, and then declare begin, exception, end, just like any other procedure or function or anything like that. Okay, so basically what all is important, some things are optional, like create or replace trigger is important, before, after is important, insert, update, delete is important. So you need to remember the first three lines are going to be there in any particular trigger. So create or replace trigger, when, before, after or what, on what, on this table. Okay, basically this, and then you're going to reference and then the restings are as told before. So let's see an example. So this is an example. So create or replace trigger, whatever the trigger name is. In this case, the trigger name is display underscore sad underscore change. When is this trigger going to be fired? Before. Before what? Before delete or insert or update. Okay. Before delete or insert or update. On what? On which table? Customers. Okay. On is table name. Hence, on customers. For each row. And I am not writing this line, referencing old as O, new as N. I can simply use new also. So when condition, I'm going to give any condition. So my condition is when new dot id is greater than 0. Basically whenever any new id is greater than 0, this needs to be triggered, this trigger needs to be fired. And what needs to be done in that case? That is between declare and declare begin and end. So in declare, I'm declaring a number variable which is sal underscore div, and in between begin and end, I am going to calculate the salary difference between the new salary and the old salary, because we are deleting or inserting or updating a salary. So in that case, the salary difference is going to be new dot salary. New is our new row, new data, whatever, minus old dot salary. Okay, and then I'm going to print that dbms underscore output output line salary differences salary diff. And this is an example in trigger. I hope you all understood it. Thank you for watching.